corporate governance best practices by corporate entities.
Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria, ICSEM, the hub of governance professionals.
Good evening and welcome to Corporate Governance Platform, proudly brought to you by the Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria, ICSEM. To our Muslim viewers, we say Eid Mubarak. I am your anchorman, Tunde Odeyemi, and in today's episode, we are going to take a look at the topic examining the link between good governance in the public sector and corporate governance in the private sector. To do justice to this topic is a distinguished fellow of the Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria, Mr. Onyekachi Uko. Mr. Uko holds a Bachelor of Law degree from the University of Benin in 1987 and was called to the Nigerian Bar. He was elected Associate of the Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria in 2009 and became a Fellow of the Institute in 2016. Mr. Uko served in the Law Reform Committee and the AGM and Conference Planning Committee of ICSAN for 4 years. He was also a former Financial Secretary of the Lagos Chapter of the Institute. Currently, he is a member of the Finance and General Purpose Committee of the Institute and the Chairman Editorial Committee for the Flagship, a professional publication of the chapter. Mr. Uko is into private practice and is married with children. Mr. Onyekachi Uko, you are welcome to Corporate Governance Platform.
Thank you. Good evening, viewers, and happy Salah celebrations to our Muslim brethren. Thank you.
Thank you for finding time to come for this show on a special day like this.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, we are discussing the link between good governance in the public sector and corporate governance in the private sector. And I'd like to kick off this discussion by asking you, what does corporate governance connote?
Well, corporate governance connotes a system of rules, processes, and policies by which a corporation is administered or operated. If you can put it in a layman's language.
Okay.
It's a corporate governance ensures that companies are run within the law for the optimal benefit of all stakeholders.
The companies are run within the law.
Within the law.
For the benefit of all stakeholders. I love that. For the benefit of all stakeholders. Is there any difference between corporate governance and corporate management?
Yes, there are different issues, though they're related.
Okay.
In corporate governance, like I've stated, is concerned with the rules, procedures, policies, processes. Corporate governance is concerned with protecting the business. Corporate management refers to the management of a company.
Okay.
Corporate management is concerned with growing the business to ensure that the business is run efficiently and effectively. So the two are different. But they're related in that corporate management should drive the corporate governance processes of a company or a corporation.
Okay, the corporate management should drive the corporate governance processes.
Yes.
Because when you say corporate management is about the growth of the company.
That is true.
I wanted to ask, is corporate governance not about the growth of the company?
Corporate governance is actually concerned with protecting that the corporation or entity abides by the law. So the company is protected. It's not so much concerned about the growth or the profitability of the business. Ensuring that the rules are followed and the rules are maintained. While corporate management is about growing it, it is run efficiently and effectively. And the ways to do this is to imbibe the corporate governance processes as stated by the law, the policies.
Is to imbibe the corporate governance policies.
Yes.
Okay. Now, how would you define good governance in public administration context?
Well, by good governance, I would like to see some principles. For example, if you say good governance, I would like to see things like principles like the rule of law.
Okay.
In public administration, the rule of law must be maintained.
Okay.
Public entities must abide by the rule of law. Well, it's covered that in this country, public entities behave as if they are above the law. Take for example, a judgment obtained against a corporate body, a public institution.
Okay.
Your challenge now would be how to enforce the judgment. And you discover that nothing happens, it should not be so. By good governance, I also like to see things like transparency. in the public sector. There should be transparency. Contracts should be awarded according to the rules and regulations of the entity. I also like to see in the public sector that public corporations are constituted in accordance with the Enabling Act. For example, you have stations where interim managing directors are appointed without a board, or where interim boards are appointed, and this board stays on for many years. So all this should be corrected. They are not good governance when you say things like this. I also like to say accountability. Public sector should be accountable. I'd like to see honesty in public administration. I also like to see participation. There should be whistleblowing. Where there are infractions, this infraction should be mentioned. And people who commit infractions should be sanctioned. Okay. So when I see these things, I will not say there's good governance in public administration.
Okay, what then is the link between corporate governance and public governance?
Yes, the link is that they share similar principles.
Okay.
Like I mentioned, the rule of law. Rule of law is also applicable to corporate governance.
Corporate governance, yes.
It's also applicable to
public governance. Public governance,
yes. I also mentioned transparency.
Okay.
This same principle applies to both sectors. I also mentioned accountability. Okay. This same principle applies to both sectors. And all they share similar principles. That is it.
Okay, let me take the question a little bit further.
Okay.
Some school of thought believes, and they also mentioned that public governance and corporate governance are much alike.
That is true.
Okay. How true or how false do you think this statement is?
Yes, they are much alike in that they share principles. But however, the aims and objectives or the dynamics in the private sector and the public sector are not the same.
Okay.
Like in the private sector, the major objective is to make profits. While in the public sector, the major objective, while they can make money, major objective will be the public well-being. Maybe they provide an essential or critical
services.
Yes. So the they are like, but corporate governance may not apply the same way it applies in the private sector to the public sector. In that the considerations are different.
Okay. Even though they have the same mindset principles,
yes.
But they aim at different things. Now, what are the benefits, or let me say the implications of a company? If a company is reputed for adhering to principles of corporate governance, what are the implications?
Yes, the business environment is quite challenging.
Okay.
In that there are risks. For example, there are some risks can be foreseen and the steps taken to correct it. Some risks, even though foreseen, nothing can be done about it.
Okay.
While some risks cannot be foreseen at all. So companies that imbibe corporate governance practices, very strong corporate practices, are more suited to survive the harsh economic environment. Yes.
Wonderful.
Yes. And besides, corporate governance has some aims. Even in good governance, in public sector, also has some aims. And some of the aims are, one, to avoid mismanagement. Two, to position the corporation to have better access to capital. Three, to mitigate risk. And four, to safeguard stakeholders' investment. So companies that imbibe strong corporate governance practices enjoy these benefits.
Okay. We have talked about the company. Let's talk about the nation.
Okay.
Now, what benefits would accrue to a nation that is reputed now for adhering to the principles of corporate governance?
A nation reputed to adhere to the principles of corporate governance will have a better investor confidence.
Okay.
You know, it also have a better ratings with the rating agencies. You know, investors are not charity organizations. They invest with the purpose to have a return of the money, also to have the security of the money that are being brought in. So the investors are more attracted where a country applies corporate governance principles. It will boost the economy and it will create jobs in the economy.
Okay, let's look at that. Is that beneficial to the company or beneficial to the nation?
It's beneficial to everybody.
It's beneficial to everybody.
Yes, but in both the nation and both the country.
Okay. Now, is there a link between entrenchment of corporate governance? You mentioned something similar anyway.
Okay.
Between entrenchment of corporate governance in a country and the flow of foreign investment into the country.
Yes, that is true. That's correct. I believe if the corporate governance is entrenched in the country, there'll be an increased flow on foreign investment, in that investors' confidence is strong in that economy. You know, economies that have very good investor confidence attract a lot of investments. Yes.
Okay, could that be the reason why the nation as a whole also, you know, encourage the launching of the Nigerian Code of Corporate Governance 2018?
Yes. It's one of the reasons for launching the code. And the code applies to both the private sector and the public sector. And it has very good principles that if companies abide by it, the risk of corporate failures in the country will be minimized.
Okay. Let me ask this question. How would you assess the state of adherence to corporate governance in Nigeria? We are being specific about Nigeria. How would you assess the state of adherence to corporate governance?
Corporate governance in Nigeria is still very low.
Okay.
It would seem that the multinational companies have very strong corporate governance practices.
Okay.
Compared to the local companies. I was reading in the news some time ago that even I would not like to mention names because it's not appropriate, that some of the old institutions are having corporate governance challenges, leading to the apex regulatory body to intervene by removing the board and appointing a new one. This should not be so. So it shows you the level of corporate governance compliance in the country. It's still very low. We still have a long way to go to meet international standards.
Is there anything that can be done to improve on this?
Yes. I would think that companies should make it a standard to abide by all the principles as enshrined in Nigerian Code of Corporate Governance. They have very good principles that if it is followed, this issue will be corrected.
Okay. If these principles are followed, there will be improvement in corporate governance. At this point, we'd like to go for a very short break. When we come back, we continue the discussion on the link between good governance and corporate governance. Please don't go away.
Corporate Governance Platform, a program from the Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria, ICSA, is now at your doorstep.
By the way, what is corporate governance and what are its key pillars?
Would there be any conflict of interest if a person combines the roles of a chairman and a chief executive officer in a corporate organization?
What can Nigeria do to gain international recognition in the context of the application of corporate governance?
These are many more questions will be answered on
Corporate Governance Platform, a program designed to inform and educate our numerous viewers on the adoption of corporate governance best practices by corporate entities.
Join the Corporate Governance Platform crew every Thursday at 4:30 p.m. on MITV, your talent station, via DSTV 255 and UHF 43.
Corporate Governance Platform, your strategy for the adoption of corporate governance best practices by corporate entities.
Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria, ICSEN, the heart of governance professionals.
You are welcome back. It's the Corporate Governance Platform, proudly brought to you by the Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria. And we are still discussing the link between good governance and in the public sector and corporate governance in the private sector. And I see with me in the studio, Mr. Oyekashi Uko, dealing and leading the conversation on that very important topic. Mr. Uko, you told us some of the things that the government can do to improve on our corporate governance. I know the government has started with the Nigerian Code of Corporate Governance. I would like to ask, would you subscribe to the fact that code should be made mandatory for different organizations in Nigeria?
Yes, I would not subscribe to the idea of it being made mandatory. In that, if you make it mandatory, enforcement may be a major problem. In any case, at the stage of our economic development, we are not really the stage where we make the code mandatory. But I will subscribe that maybe there should be more enlightenment around the code.
Around the code.
Then okay. The benefits of the code can be sold to both the private and the public sector. And there should be more education. And a time frame can be given for companies to comply. After that time frame elapses, then the issue of making it mandatory can be taken up. But okay. For now, I will not.
After having done the enlightenment, then yes. The issue of mandatory can come in.
Yes.
It seems the code actually focuses on the private institutions. Do you think there is any relevance in that code to public sector as well?
No, the code actually it says for both the private and public, the public sectors of the economy. But we know in this country, it's mostly the private sector that actually complies with matters of corporate governance, in that they exist to make a profit, the shareholders elect the directors who report to them, so they must make a profit. Otherwise, the directors cannot retain their jobs. So the private sector is more compliant with matters of corporate governance than the public sector.
Because there is this profit drive that is driving the private sector, and we don't have it in the public sector.
Yes, in the public sector, even though we don't have the profit drive, but there are reasons why they exist.
Okay.
There are things like issues of well-being. It could be they are providing a critical service to the country, and whatever they are doing should be done well. So every sector, both the private and the public, should imbibe the principles as enshrined in the code. But the code, as it stands, is meant both for the public, private, and the public sectors of the economy.
Okay. I want to talk about a very critical part of governance, and that is succession planning.
All right.
Will you say the concept of succession planning is as critical in public sector as it is to the private sector?
Succession planning is a very good development, but I will not say it is critical in the public sector.
Okay.
The reason being that the dynamics in the public sector is quite different from what plays out in the private sector. Now, if you take example the private sector, a public quoted company, you see an instance where an MD or a chairman can grow his son to succeed him because he has the majority shareholding in the organization or in the company. And as long as the son is qualified, that is normal. It's accepted. But in the public sector, will it be wise for a DG, an outgoing DG, to grow his own son too, to replace him when he retires? That will be unethical. So the dynamics in the public sector are different from the public sector. In the public sector, there are more pool of funds to select from. In any case, there are other considerations. You have to look at issues like gender balancing, issues like geopolitical balancing. For example, a current DG, it not be appropriate that the same somebody from the same area than he is not brought in to replace him. That would cause an outcry. There has to be some balance. Maybe somebody from another section of the country can be brought in to head that agency. So there should be some balance. What to my view is important is that whoever is brought in to succeed and as being a MD or chairman in the public sector should be qualified.
Okay. I would like to take you up on that. I know in the public sector there are a lot of variables that comes in. And these variables are what we refer to as politics in the public sector. Now, in the private sector, how appropriate is it for a chairman or an MD, even though you have the highest number of shares, to grow your son, even though the son is qualified to become a director in such company?
Well, it depends on the circumstances. The important consideration is a qualification. Is the son qualified? Because the truth of the matter is that the companies will act based on the resolutions.
Okay.
And if a decision is put to a vote, the majority shareholder, in view of the amount of shares he holds, will carry the day. So it depends on the qualification. If the son is qualified, he can assume that position. And there are instances where even some banks or other public quoted companies, quoted companies,
yes,
where their sons succeeded them, and the great authority give approval. So it depends on the circumstances. What is important is the qualification. If the son is qualified for that job or role, I mean, he can assume that position.
Okay. What advice do you have for both private and public sectors in Nigeria on the issues of good governance?
Well, I will encourage both private and public sectors to abide by the provisions as enshrined in the Nigerian Code of Corporate Governance 2018. The code has provisions that covers every area of corporate governance. I would recommend in particular at principles 14, 15, and 19 of the code. Principle 14 talks about honor body evaluation.
Okay.
But the evaluation can be facilitated by a standard consultant every three years. There, the board itself is evaluated. The board committees are evaluated. And individual directors are also evaluated. And that principle 14, this says that where an individual director is evaluated and there are shortcomings, that the company can arrange training to bring the director up to the standard required. Then principle 15 talks about corporate governance evaluation. There, the company will do an audit of its corporate governance processes and now benchmark it against the standards provided in the code.
Okay.
And where there are areas of shortcoming, then you can take steps to correct it.
Okay.
Then article principle 19 talks about whistleblowing. It gives a very good detailed framework of how whistleblowing could be in place in a company. I believe if these principles are followed for companies, then they will enjoy the benefits of corporate governance, which is they will avoid the mismanagement of resources. They will protect investors, shareholders' investments. Then they will mitigate risks, and also keep on going as a growing concern.
Okay, these are benefits that are accruable if you follow all the principles.
Yes.
May I ask if there is, because in your opening remark, you actually mentioned that corporate governance is about rules and regulations,
that is true,
and we have a lot of principles. Now, if there is a breach of these principles by either public institutions or private institutions, what do you recommend?
Well, if there's a breach, then I believe the sanctions should be followed. The appropriate authorities or the regulatory body should apply the appropriate sanctions.
And are we not making this mandatory then, if there are sanctions?
some corporations belong to regulated environment. Take for example the banks, insurance companies.
Okay.
So even apart from the code, the other rules, sectoral rules that govern them. So where there are infractions, I'm sure the regulatory bodies will apply sanctions.
Okay, in their different sectors of the economy.
Okay.
Yeah, in what ways have the institute, I mean the Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria, ICSAN, in what way have they been promoting good governance in both private and public sectors in Nigeria?
Well, the institute has been in the forefront of promoting corporate governance in Nigeria. Every annually, we have a program called the Roundtable on Corporate Governance.
Okay.
It is held annually, where issues of corporate governance are discussed. Also, the issues also does training, do at a fee, to organizations, other corporate bodies, on issues of a corporate governance. It can help you train your staff on matters of corporate governance, or give lectures or seminars. We also have a public lecture series, which is held annually, where issues of corporate governance are discussed.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes, and we also have annual conferences, seminars, webinars, and all these conferences, the main topic discussed is one aspect of corporate governance or the other. So the institute is actually called the hub of corporate governance because we are in the forefront of corporate governance in Nigeria.
Okay, and if I may add, this program, Corporate Governance Platform, is another way that the institute is promoting good governance in the public and private sectors. Lastly, distinguished fellow of ICSAN, is what is your final word for managers of public institutions and private institutions on good governance?
Well, my final word would be that, like I said before, they should try to abide by all the principles of corporate governance as enshrined in Nigerian Code of Governance, Corporate Governance 2018, okay. because it has a lot of benefits for the company going forward as a going concern.
Thank you very much. Public institutions and private sector should try as much as possible to abide by the rules and the principles of corporate governance. Thank you very much, Mr. Oyinkachi Uko, for coming on the show.
Thank you, sir. Thank you,
viewers. I enjoyed the discussion so much, and I believe our viewers also enjoyed the discussion. This is where we wrap it up and call it a day on this special edition of Corporate Governance Platform. It's been interesting discussing this particular topic with our guest, Mr. Oyinkachi Uko, distinguished fellow of the Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria. Thank you very much for being on the show. We invite you to join us again next week, same station, same time. God bless you. Bye for now.
Thank you, sir.
Corporate Governance Platform, a program from the Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators of Nigeria, ICSA, is now at your doorstep.
By the way, what is corporate governance and what are its key pillars?
Would there be any conflict of interest if our person combines the roles of our chairman and our chief executive officer in a corporate organization?
What can Nigeria do to get international recognition in the context of the application of corporate governance?
These are many more questions will be answered on
Corporate Governance Platform, a program designed to inform and educate our numerous viewers on the adoption of corporate governance best practices by corporate entities.
Join the Corporate Governance Platform crew every Thursday at 4:30 p.m. on MITV, your talent station, via DSTV 255 and UHF 43.
Corporate Governance Platform, your strategy for the adoption of corporate.